Hey guys, we are on part three of our miracles series, and today we're talking about John chapter 11. So if you got your Bibles with you, pull out John chapter 11. We're going to talk about through verse 44, 1 through 44. It's the story of Jesus raising Lazarus from the dead. It might be a little different from a way that you've heard it before. We're going to spend more time on Bible here than we have in the last two parts. So here's the key, I believe. It's found in verse 33. If you go through the whole thing, the struggle that Jesus is dealing with is that he's telling his disciples Lazarus is going to be okay, and they're like, yeah, you know, I'm not sure he's going to be okay. Then he tells, let's see, Martha, and Martha's like, yeah, maybe he'll be okay, like in the future, like when, you know, the resurrection comes, when we all get raised from the dead. And he's like, no, I'm telling you, he's asleep. Then Mary doesn't believe. Then he says to open the tomb, and they're like, no, it's going to stink. And it says twice that Jesus gets angry. So in verse 33, all the people are wailing and crying and they're not believing him. And he's like, it says a deep anger welled up within him. He was deeply troubled, right? And this is the verse in verse 35 where it says Jesus wept, right? So when you're a little kid, you're memorizing Bible verses, you're like, oh, I can memorize Jesus wept, right? But I've always thought it before as Jesus wept, like Jesus was sad with his friends who were sad because Lazarus was a good friend, Mary and Martha, good friends. So he's like, oh, you know, I'm sad too. No, I think he wept at the lack of faith, at the unbelief, because then right after that, it says he gets angry again. It says in verse 38, Jesus was still angry as he arrived at the tomb. That's when he says, roll the stone aside. But Martha says, no, he's been dead. And Jesus responds in verse 40. I can just hear his tone. He's like, didn't I tell you that you would see God's glory if you believe? Read that again. Didn't I tell you that you would see God's glory if you believe? So they roll the stone aside. Jesus looks up to heaven and says, Father, thank you for hearing me. You always hear me. But I said it out loud. That's when his voice probably got a little louder. But I said it out loud for the sake of all these people standing here, so that they will believe you sent me. Here's the deal. We've talked about the last two parts of the series on miracles. We've talked about hearing from God, essentially, the word of knowledge, right? And then yesterday. So today what we're saying is when we hear from God, we've got to believe. When we hear from God, we've got to believe. That might sound so simple. We've already talked about in the past, in other series we've done about Hebrews 11, where it says, without faith it's impossible to please God, because you've got to believe that he exists and that he's a rewarder of those who seek him. But here, what we're saying is, when he speaks to you, we've got to move forward without hesitation. Here's a great example, a very simple one, but a great example. I've got three girls. If I said to my girls, tonight I'm going to take you to a movie, it's a Disney movie, it's a Pixar movie, you've been wanting to see it, you love it, you know, you can't wait to see this movie, and I am taking you tonight. I promise you, I'm taking you tonight. I can't wait. Go get dressed. We're going to get in the car. And they say, are you really taking me tonight? Are you really going to take us tonight? I'm like, yeah, I just told you, go get dressed. And they're like, but are you really going to? And I'm like, what do you mean? Why do you keep questioning? I just told you, of course I'm going to take you tonight. I mean, why would I just told you, why would I not? Are you really going to take us? You know what? I'm not going to take you. You know, if you don't believe what I'm telling you, if you're going to keep questioning it, as opposed to getting in the car and going with me to see this movie, then we're not going to go. And I'm not trying to preach a message of, if you don't have faith, that's why miracles don't happen. But I am trying to tell you that in John chapter 11, I believe the reason Jesus gets angry twice is not because his heart is breaking for the people. Why would his heart need to break? I mean, it's not breaking for the people because Lazarus died. It's breaking for the people because they lack faith. Because Jesus' heart's not breaking because Lazarus is dead, because he's already said he's not dead. He said he's just sleeping, right? Jesus' heart is breaking as a father's heart would break if he says to his kids, I'm going to take you to the movie tonight, and they don't believe him. What we've got to do, this requires risk once again. If you want the Holy Spirit to act and move in your life, if we want the Holy Spirit to act and move in our life, it requires risk. It always comes with risk. Holy Spirit always comes with risk. So when he speaks a word, we first take the risk to even listen. Then we take the risk to believe. And then out of that belief, we take the risk to act, right? So God is calling for us to believe, to listen, to believe, and to act. And that's what he desires desperately. And he says, I'm going to do miracles just so you can see and believe and then act. But he says, blessed are you who believe who have not even seen. So the challenge today on Miracles Part 3 is when we hear him, to believe and act in that belief. If we believe, you know, somebody's going to be healed, then you've got to live that way. You've got to think that way. If we believe that he's going to provide, you've got to live without anxiousness. You've got to live without worry. You've got to sleep good at night, right? Or else you're not believing. So and if you're not believing, then don't beat yourself up, but say, God, give me belief. Give me faith. Help me have faith, because I know Hebrews 11 says you want me to have it. John 11 says you want me to have it. I need to walk in it. I need to work in it. That's how you're going to please him, right? And that's how you're going to live your life. So anyway, I think you get the point, right? We've got to walk and believe without hesitation when we hear from God. That's so key to miracles happening in our life. All right, thanks, everybody. We'll talk to you again on part 4 of Miracles.